The uniform of the Highland soldier at the outbreak of the First World War represented a unique blend of tradition and practicality. The Army's standard uniform was altered to incorporate national and regimental identity. Here we see a soldier of the Black Watch getting dressed in 1914. Soldiers were issued a woolen shirt known as a greyback. The soldier's regiment and number were printed on a piece of white fabric on the front of the shirt. They were also issued a pair of woolen socks and drawers. Diced hose tops were worn over the socks. The hose tops were held up by garters tied around the calf, which displayed a decorative red flash of regimental pattern. Khaki gaiters, or spats, were worn over Highland shoes. In the Black Watch, these had white buttons, and the toe was cut square. The shoes were similar to the boots issued to soldiers in other regiments, but provided no ankle support. The kilt was made from 7 yards of government tartan and fastened with pins. It was worn high on the waist, with the hem reaching the centre of the kneecap. In cold weather, the waistcoat cardigan could be worn, either under or over the kilt. The kilt apron was held in place by hooks at the rear of the kilt and tied at the right-hand side. This served to protect the kilt and keep it clean, as well as providing some camouflage. The service dress jacket was altered by the battalion's tailors to allow the sporran to be worn. As the war progressed, this became a less frequent occurrence, as new jackets were issued without this alteration. In fact, the majority of soldiers who embarked for France with the 1st Battalion, the Black Watch, in 1914, were reservists wearing newly issued and unaltered jackets. The 1908 pattern web equipment carried everything the soldier needed to live and fight, including ammunition, water bottle, mess tins, entrenching implement, and bayonet. The soldier's regiment was identified by shoulder titles. In this case, the letters RH, standing for Royal Highlanders, the secondary title of the Black Watch. The Glengarry cap was blue, with a red tourie, no rosette, and a leather headband. The cap badge, or star, was worn on the left. Although well suited to the mobile opening phase of the war, this uniform proved impractical for the nature of trench warfare. By the end of 1914, boots and puttees had replaced the Highland shoes and gaiters, and bright diced hose tops soon gave way to drab and khaki versions. The Glengarry was replaced by more practical headdresses, which in turn gave way to the steel helmet. However, except in a few isolated instances, the kilt remained an integral part of the Highland soldier's garb. It would take another global conflict before it was consigned to a purely ceremonial role.